and welcome back to the Green Dragon Channel, and welcome back to my tiny little series on how I design costumes. This time I will be dealing with sketching and my process on a more creative scale, and this will be a video where I'm sketching and making the final rendering of the costume. This is not going to be a how to draw or paint or whatever. It's not a tutorial or anything like that. Excuse you. Get out of here. It is merely showing my creative process. So, yeah. Enjoy.
After doing all my research, I began compiling all the information I have set aside about Victorian fashion, about the character, about changelings, and I'm putting them into drawings. I did two different sketches before I found one that was more suited to who I thought Jenny Glover was. Glover? I don't know. The main colors that I'm thinking of are a lavender gray and a creamy white. The second sketch is closest to what I've ended up with in the final product, which you will see in a moment, and I'll explain more about the design choices once you start seeing me make the final product.
You taught me.
You can also see me making some notes just to remind myself of little tiny things that I might not remember if I was looking just at the sketch.
That never. As you can see, I am making this rendering with chalk pastel. I was taught when I was studying to use watercolor for most of my renderings, but I am not terribly confident in watercolor, and I love chalk pastel, so I decided to do it this way, because no one's holding me accountable for anything, and I'm not being graded. Also, I'm not doing a full body portrait, because, again, I'm not doing this professionally, it's just for joy. And because I am doing chalk pastel, the way you do it is a little different from other mediums, and so just be aware that the stuff that I'm doing will not look human or pretty for a long time. It takes a lot of adjusting. I am spending a lot of time on the details of the face on this particular one. I probably wouldn't normally. The face is very important to the character, but, you know, you'd think the clothes would be the most important thing. But for this character, because I'm making it for a real person, I prefer to use her face, or as close to it as I can with my own particular style. So I just found a picture of Momo online, and I'm using a rather sly face of hers. Not necessarily the sweetest or most innocent or character appropriate, but I liked it.
Glittering crowds and shimmering clouds and canyons of steel. They're making me feel. I'm home. It's autumn in New York that brings the promise of new love.
For the hair, I decided on a very soft, almost half up, half down, but I guess the Victorian version of that. A nice soft updo with a lovely tendril down the side, and just in the beautiful golden hair that Momo already has.
May sigh for exotic lands. It's autumn in New York. It's good to live it again.
I decided on a higher, more restrained and modest neckline for the character. Since she has such a hard time connecting with people, this is one way to show that. I did decide on a more opaque cream chiffon that is a tiny bit see-through though, so that, you know, there's still the possibility of her bonding with other people. I also put the same color in a more solid fabric near the bottom peeking out of the overskirt with what I would hope to be broomstick pleats, but I mean, I'm not actually making the costume, so I don't know.
We'll tell you that it's divine. This autumn in New York transforms the slums into Mayfair. Autumn in New York, you'll need no castle in Spain.
Now, in terms of my color choice of a lavender gray, in her video, Momo stated that she really loves pastels and soft florals. And I was thinking, okay, but what's the most somber pastel color that I can get away with? Lavender? Okay, we could put some gray in there. That works. Yeah, just interspersed with cream. That's girly, pastel, cute. It counts.
It must have been moon glow. Way up in the blue, it must have been moon glow that led me straight to you. I still hear you saying, dear one, hold me fast. And I start in praying, oh Lord, please let this last. We seem to float right through air. Heavenly songs seem to come from everywhere. And now when there's moon glow, way up in the blue.
You can see me putting some wrinkly value into the skirt, which appears to be quite bunchy. I am attempting to make the skirt look like it is bustled in several places. The bustles will be held up by little chunks. Chunks isn't a very elegant word, but I don't know, little spaces, places of embroidery that I will explain in greater detail once I start drawing it.
It must have been moon glow, way up in the blue. It must have been moon glow that
led me. I decided to also have a cream-colored belt or girdle or sash, whatever you want to call it, to break up the vast expanse of lavender, gray, and somberness. Just again to emphasize Jenny's purity and her innocence. The belt will also be embroidered. You can also see the cuffs that I've put on the sleeves are that same cream color. In my very first rough sketch that you saw me do, there were some black fingerless gloves on there. Just another way to show restraint, and this is my more subtle version of that. Now, the embroidery that I have started to do, excuse me, are tiny little lilacs. Now, in Victorian times, symbolism was extremely popular, especially when it came to the language of flowers. And so I was doing some research on all of that good stuff, and lilacs apparently symbolize remembrance, usually of a lost love or something like that. But, you know, I was thinking, remembrance, lost memories before she was 15, perhaps. That's close enough. Sounds good to me. Let's do it.
Love that's fresh and still unspoiled. Love that's only slightly soiled.
One of my favorite things to do in costuming is to add tiny little details that in theater, for instance, the audience might never know, but that the actor and the designer do. In this case, the LARPer. It would help roleplay and all that good stuff. The locket that I've put in there might contain some sort of keepsake, for instance, a hair of a loved one that was lost. Victorians were obsessed with hair jewelry, sometimes of dead relatives. Not creepy at all. It's sweet, I guess. I was originally thinking of doing an additional sketch with some sort of overcoat and a hat, but I really liked Momo's ensemble for her character introduction video, so I didn't do that. Also a view showing the boots and the shorter skirt, but again, she kind of already took care of that with her references to Mary Poppins, so I didn't do that.
I know every type of love better far than they.
If you want. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and please check out Momo O'Brien's channel. Her video is really, really cool. I like all of her stuff. I'm a huge fan. I love it. Anyway, I'm gonna stop talking because now I just sound like a stuttering idiot. Okay, bye!